إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد، The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the authentic hadith, الدعاء هو العبادة. دعاء, supplication, is by itself is worship, and all worship is about the dua. In another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ad-du'a mukhu al-ibadah." That dua is the core of worship. Because when you ask, you are presenting your weakness, and you are acknowledging the power and the ability of that person that you are asking of. And we as humans, we are all weak and we are all in need. Look at the child when he wants to have something and he knows that he cannot have it by himself. He will go to the person that he knows that, number one, will listen to him. Number two, will be kind. Number three, will give. So he will go to his mother. Imagine when you need something and you ask Allah, who is more kind? Who is more merciful? Who has the ability? Who is the one that everything is in his hand? Allah Azza wa Jalla. وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. We don't like people asking from us. We don't. Even the father gets tired from his son when he keeps asking. It's our habit. That's the way we are built. We are humans. We don't like someone else to ask from us. Allah Azza wa Jalla is the opposite. Allah Azza wa Jal is ordering us to ask from Him. وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ أُدْعُونِي. Ask. Ask what? Anything that you want. And then, أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. I shall give you what you have asked for. Just look into your life and see how many times the door was blocked and you needed something and you ask Allah Azza wa Jal and the door is open. Just look into your life and see how many times. In another verse, Allah Azza wa Jal said, وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعان. And if my servants ask you about me, tell them, inform them that I am near, close to them. So let them ask from me, and I shall give them. And that was the practice of the prophets, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. زكريا عليه السلام أسأل الله عز وجل قال ربي لا تذرني فردا وأنت خير الوارثين. Oh Allah عز وجل, don't leave me without any child. And he was so old, and his wife was so old. Allah عز وجل accepted his dua and blessed him with Yahya. Ayyub عليه الصلاة والسلام, after being patient 18 years, then he raised his hand. ربي قد مسني الضر وأنت أرحم الراحمين. Oh Allah, look at my situation, and you are the most merciful. And Allah Azza wa Jal accepted his dua, and immediately he was cured. And all the prophets, all of them, just read the chapter of Al-Anbiya and look how the prophets are asking Allah Azza wa Jal. And our prophet محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. One time عائشة رضي الله عنها, she said, I saw the prophet, he was praying, and she said, I saw the prophet in a good mood. So after he finished the prayer, she said to him, Prophet of Allah, make supplication for me. Of course, she is his wife, and she saw her husband. He is the prophet of Allah Azza wa Jal. His dua is accepted, and he is in a good mood. So she wanted to seize that opportunity. So she asked the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, O Prophet of Allah, make supplication for me. So the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, O Allah, forgive all the sins of Aisha, the past and the future, and what she has hidden and what she has made appearance. Aisha radiyallahu anha, she was so pleased, and she was smiling and laughing to the point that she put her head on the lap of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Aisha, are you happy with my supplication? Did my supplication made you happy? So she said, of course, O Prophet of Allah, how I couldn't be happy with such beautiful dua. The Prophet ﷺ said to Aisha, by Allah, this is my dua to my ummah. Every prayer, the Prophet ﷺ is making dua for me and you. Thus, we have to practice this worship. We have to ask Allah Azza wa Jalla. There is nothing that you can lose. Raise your hand and ask Allah Azza wa Jal. What are the guarantees?
We are humans, you know, we want to have some guarantees. Okay, I want to make dua. What are the guarantees? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, ما من عبد مسلم يدعو بدعوة ليس بها إثم أو قطيعة رحم. Any Muslim on this earth make a supplication, but it's not a bad supplication. It's not a supplication that will cut the ties of your relatives, or you're making a dua on someone that is going to be harmed. A dua. إِلَّا أَعْطَاهُ اللَّهِ إِحْدَى الثَّلَاثِ. Allah Azza wa Jal, this is the guarantee now. Every time you make the dua, you are guaranteed one of those three. إِمَّا أَنْ يُعَجِّلْ لَهُ دَعْوَتَهُ. Allah Azza wa Jal will give you what you have asked for. This is number one. You make the dua, oh Allah Azza wa Jal, bless me, bless my wife, bless my family. Oh Allah Azza wa Jal, make my sons, my children successful at school. Oh Allah Azza wa Jal, I just started a business, make it successful. Oh, whatever you ask, whatever you want. Number one, the first option, Allah Azza wa Jal will give you what you have asked for. أو ادخرها له ليوم القيامة. Allah Azza wa Jal will not give you what you have asked for, not because He does not want to give you what you have asked for, because of His knowledge subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knows that this thing is not good for you. You might say, no, I know, I know. No, Allah Azza wa Jal knows better. So Allah Azza wa Jalla will not give you what you have asked for, but He will reserve it to you in the day of judgment. In the day of judgment, where every one of us would love to have one, only one, good deeds. Then Allah Azza wa Jalla will show you the rewards, this huge reward, and say, but what is it? I didn't do that. This is, you remember that supplication that you've made, and I did not give you what you have asked for because it was not good for you. I kept it for you for this day, and you get that reward. At that time, everyone would wish that all my supplication would have been reserved for me. This is number two, or option two. The third option, Allah Azza wa Jal will take away from you something bad. Something bad that is going to happen to you. But with your supplication, Allah Azza wa Jal will remove that bad thing that might happen to you. You are in need to travel, and you made the reservation, and you ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make that trip easy for you, and you go, and then something happened. You are rejected, you are being cancelled, whatever, and the flight is gone, and your appointment is gone, and you are sad. I made the dua, and my flight is gone. And then you hear the bad news. What have happened? Allah Azza wa Jal removed that bad thing that would have happened to you because of your dua. Thus, let us always, always practice to ask Allah Azza wa Jal. Whenever you come to the masjid, you pray the two rak'ah, make the dua. You finish the prayer, make the dua. You are in your car, make the dua. You are at home, make the dua. You are in the office, make the dua. There is no specific position for the dua. Just make it. Make it the habit. Because if you know Allah Azza wa Jal, get to know Allah Azza wa Jal, when in ease time, Allah Azza wa Jal will know you at the difficult times. May Allah Azza wa Jal accept from us
and enable us to do what is good and guide us to do what is good. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.